Good morning, Sprayberry. Today is October 31st, and happy Halloween!
At this time, we'll have the...
When most people think of Halloween, they think of trick-or-treating, parades, bobbing for apples, and other family-friendly activities. But bet you didn't know the true story behind the ancient origins of Halloween. It all goes back some 2,000 years to the ancient Celtic festival known as Samhain, celebrated on November 1st. On the night before Samhain, people believed that the dead returned as ghosts. They would leave food and wine on their doorsteps to keep roaming spirits at bay and wear masks when they left the house so they would be mistaken for fellow ghosts. The Christian church turned Samhain into All Saints' Day, or All Hallows, in the 8th century. The night before became All Hallows' Eve, later shortened to Halloween. You've heard of trick-or-treating on Halloween, but what about souling or guising? All three of these traditions originated in medieval Britain. On All Souls' Day, November 2nd, the needy would beg for pastries known as soul cakes. In return, they would pray for people's dead relatives. This was called souling. In the medieval Halloween tradition of guising, young people would dress up in costume and accept food, wine, money, and other offerings in exchange for singing, reciting poetry, or telling jokes. In 19th century America, Irish and Scottish immigrants revived these old traditions. The result was trick-or-treating. At first, it was much more about the tricks, in the form of pranks and hijinks, than the treats. It wasn't until the 1950s that the custom took on its current family-friendly, kid-centered form. Today, Halloween is big business, with U.S. consumers spending more than $2.5 billion on costumes annually. Add in the candy, and it's estimated that Americans spend up to $6 billion on Halloween each year, making it the second most commercial holiday after Christmas. So whether you're a fan of tricks, treats, or trivia, there's a bit of Halloween history.
We bet you didn't know!
At this time, we'll have our pledge followed by a moment of quiet reflection.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
Today's quote of the day is, be who you are and say what you feel, because those who don't mind don't matter, and those who matter don't mind.
Facts. Sprayberry will hold its mock presidential election today during all lunches. Please bring a photo identification, any form will be accepted, with you to vote. Sprayberry correctly predicted the president during the last two elections, so we will see what happens. See you at the SHS polls. Congratulations to our football team with their win against Creekview. Check out their highlights from the game.
We got London on the track. Whoa. On the track.
Yeah, man, T.I.P. To the max with it. Rex.
I count six shots.
Gussin' at the bando. Jury real metal like a panda. I went from rad to riches to a 50 with tilt. I went from smart car to a with some smart lips. And that if it need make my hip limp. I'm going fishing with these little bitty strip dips. And my bankroll kind of big dip. Woo. She gon' bring it on a big ship. Quite trail, no quick trip. I got dubs in the alley, no tip.
To our wannabe reporters for the morning announcements.
Good morning, Sprayberry. I'm Aja Ishan.
And I'm Tarek Samal, and on this day in 1517, the priest and scholar Martin Luther approaches the door of the Castle Church in Wittenberg, Germany, and nails a piece of paper to it containing 95 revolutionary opinions that will begin the Protestant Reformation.
SAT word of the day is dubious, meaning hesitating or doubting and not to be relied upon.
Prices for yearbooks will increase to $80 after today. Forms can be found outside of room 228 and 107. Congratulations to the Sprayberry Band of Gold for the outstanding performances this weekend at the Lafayette Marching Classic at Fayette County High School. The band performed two amazing shows and received the following awards: superior ratings in drum major, percussion, color guard, and band.
First in class percussion, color guard, and band, class AAA champion, highest scores of all the bands in percussion. Color guard and band awards for highest visual performance, musical performance, and general overall grand champion. Congratulations on a great day and a wonderful session, guys. Attention Model UN members, your position papers need to be emailed to Ms. Harper today by 5 p.m. Please see if you have any questions. You will also have a meeting this Wednesday. Bring your dues.
November is DECA month, and Sprayberry DECA will be celebrating this week. The purpose of DECA is to increase the awareness of DECA. On Monday, we have member appreciation with Boograms. On Tuesday, Sprayberry DECA Hearts teachers and staff, please come by the school store for breakfast treats. On Wednesday, ice cream social at the Hive during all lunches for DECA members. Thursday, own your future and dress for success. Friday, blackout / spirit day.
Apple Ruth Tutoring Services is partnering with the Council Office of Sprayberry High School to offer two free mock testing days, November 12th for the SAT and December 3rd for the ACT at HSS from 9 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. Students may take one or both mock tests. After the test, Apple Ruth will provide a free individual detailed score report that highlights personal strengths and weaknesses. Go to sprayberrycounseling.com to register.
Attention all Sway J mentors and Santa's helpers. Please return your completed applications and fun to Ms. Mullen's room in 313 as soon as possible. If you are not sure how to get to a room, we will show you. If you would like to participate in Shop of the Yellow Jacket but have not signed up, there is still time. Simply ask Ms. Mullen for an application which includes the fundraising or donation requirements. Please remember, Ms. Mullen will be only collecting funds and applications till November 4th. Participating in Sway J is an awesome way to make a difference in a child's life by making his or her Christmas special. Now back over to Nas and Amaro.
Congratulations to our NJROTC Jacket Battalion. Took first place overall out of 16 schools at Saturday's Luella Lyon Classic Sanctioned Drill Meet in Henry County. The unit received awards in 13 out of 14 possible categories, including first place in personal inspection, color guard, athletic overall, curl-ups, push-ups, second place in drill overall, unarmed X, armed X, unarmed basic, 16x100, and 8x220 relays.
Individual athletic awards went to Regal Foreman, Gabe Maxwell, Daniel Purticelli, Olson Gatant, Michael Cooper, Amanda Yancey, Felicity Finney, Katie Lutzford, Abby Trano, Mattias Prattis, Elson Reyes, Jacob Tucker, Samara Al-Faki, Christian Estrella Rodriguez, and Bador Chabaita. Now let's send it over to Kiesha for the weather. Thank God.
Hey guys, I'm Ari with the weather up there. Today's weather would be Monday, sunny with a high of 85 and a low of 59. Tuesday will be partly cloudy with a high of 81 and a low of 58. And Wednesday will be cloudy, 10% rain, or chance of rain, let's hope not, with a high of 84 and a low of 57. Now back over to Amro and Nas.
Congratulations to Lauren Alger, Kalia Davis, Neve Taylor, Mia Lopez, Alex Frey, and Jermaine Simmons for earning the Statesman Award at the DECA Fall Leadership Conference last week. These students earned this award by scoring a 90 or above on the Statesman exam.
Also, congratulations to Jermaine Simmons for being recognized as a young entrepreneur for his custom t-shirt design business at the conference.
Remember, teachers, all announcements must be submitted before 8 o'clock.
That's for each day, and again, the address is sprayberrynews@gmail.com.
And remember, Jackets,
together we swarm.